Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church. Today's the third Sunday of Advent, December 16th, 2018.
Good morning. And welcome to our worship service this morning on this special Sunday with the annual Christmas Cantata Choir. Once again, as last week, we will be using the service of the Word, which begins on page 211. And a reminder that next week, we will have communion, which normally would have been on this Sunday, being the third Sunday, but with Cantata, I've moved it to next week. So, we begin with the Word of Confession and Forgiveness on page 211 in the front of your worship book. So I'd ask that you please turn to that page and we'll invite those who came with that difficulty to please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom our hearts are open, our desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of God. Most merciful God, we confess
that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may walk in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We now begin our worship with Rejoice, Rejoice, Believers, hymn number 244 in the back of your worship. Hymn number 244.
I
where the day is dependent on the top of today's reading insert in your book. Let us pray. Stir up the wills of your faithful people, Lord God, and open our ears to the preaching of John, that rejoicing in your salvation, we may bring forth the fruits of repentance through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated, and as we have the lighting of the Advent candle, ask that you turn to hymn number 240 and sing the first light three candles for coming.
And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will keep hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
the birth of his beloved son, Jesus. What a marvelous message we sing, what a glorious story we tell, what a wonderful revelation we have of our Father's love for us. Jesus, God's gift of glory to all people, was born in Bethlehem in a manger.
In the Bible, we read in the Old Testament of God's word to promise to send us a Savior, to send us a Redeemer, to send us his love. The prophet Isaiah says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given." God would send his love to us by sending us his son, Jesus.
Mary was puzzled by this news.
She wondered how she could bear a son. After all, she was a virgin. The angel told her that she would be overshadowed by the power of the Holy Spirit and would conceive a son, the Son of God.
Upon hearing the angel's explanation, Mary's heart was tender and responsive. Her love for God overflowed to her final answer, "May it be to me as you have said."
Amen.
no room in the inn, a manger, a stable, with animals, hay for a baby's bed, swaddling clothes for a blanket. God's glory was wrapped in the beautiful mystery of love born that night. God was with Mary and Joseph as they welcomed to this world their little boy, Jesus, God's Son.
God sent his gift of glory to a most common and simple place as a sign that all men were welcome into his presence. From the highest king to the most humble shepherd boy, one and all could come. Christ has come as the glory of God's love to all people.
Thank you.
majority of the heaven host appeared with the angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
Thank you.
It is the story of power, God's power, that can save us and change us forever.
Christmas is a story of unending and unfailing love. You and I can truly behold the glory of Christmas as we go from here and live out this story by sharing it with others, the most wonderful Christmas gift of love, Jesus Christ.
As we pray together, open up your heart and receive a blessing of the glory of the Lord this Christmas. Lord Jesus, we celebrate your birth. We worship and adore you as the living Son of God, and we invite more of your glory into our hearts and lives this Christmas season. May we all be filled with Christ, the hope of glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus
and for all people according to their needs. Our response today is, hear our prayer. God, our Father, your Son bids us to pray with confidence. Give us your Spirit to see you in the person of your Son, knowing that he and none other is the one who came to bear our sins and be our Savior. Encourage us in true faith and fill us with joy, knowing he will come again to make all things new. Lord, in your mercy. Wise Father, your will is done without our prayer. Turn our hearts to you so that we trust your wise counsel in all things and trust your good and gracious providence in our daily lives, even as you bring us to eternal life. Open our hearts to all your promises, that we may know your will and receive your gifts in the gospel and the sacraments in true faith. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Kind Father, your Son gave bread to the hungry, sight to the blind, and hearing to the deaf. He made the lame to walk and cleansed the lepers. He raised the dead and preached good news to the poor. Help again your suffering people, the hungry, the poor and unemployed, the sick and dying, the grieving, and all who are anxious of heart. Graciously give them all that they need for their well-being. Give them ears to hear the good news of life and salvation, and quiet their fears with your love. Lead us to receive your daily gifts, our daily bread, with thankful hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, forgive us our sins and cleanse us from unrighteousness. Soften the hearts of those who reject your word and renew those whose faith is faltering. Open our hearts to your call of repentance and to your promise of mercy. Grant us to come to your table in true faith, gladly receiving Christ's body and blood and the forgiveness he promises. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, keep far from us Satan and all his wickedness and lies. Give us eyes to see evil and flee from it to your Son, who cast out demons and restores those who have fallen. In our last hour, bring us to yourself in peace and safety. Grant that in this day and the coming week, your Spirit would guide us in safety and godliness. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, into your hands we commit all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated as we give our tithes. As we are preparing to give our tithes and offerings, please remember that after the service in the gym, they will be filling the 40 boxes for Christmas for the needy. So if you would like to help with that, please, after the service, just go down to the gym. Thank you. Please turn to page 219 in the front of your worship book. And again, I invite those who came to that difficulty to please stand.
Thank you.
that concludes our 10:30, our service for today. Next week, Christmas, 23rd, where there will be an 8 o'clock and 10:30 service. On the 24th, Christmas Eve, there will be a 6 and 9:30 service with the handbell choir playing at 9 o'clock. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. St. John's has an outreach store open 9:30 to 1, Monday through Friday, closed on Thursday. Food pantry open Wednesdays 9 o'clock to 10:45, and Rainbow Table is on Friday from noon to 1. Everyone is welcome.